just want to get your thoughts first on being awarded D-League MVP. What was that like?
Well, honestly, that didn't cross my mind until I was told that I was going to be the MVP of the tournament, no? I mean, for me, that was, I'd say, a bonus, a reward, because my main goal really was to bring home the championship, knowing that Marinero hasn't won yet since they joined the D-League. The competition level there was pretty intense. As we all know, most teams that participated were college teams, no? So, up-tempo game, a lot of running, a lot of full court press break, stuff you don't see in the pro level. Sometimes, yeah, pero yeah, I mean, it's college basketball for you, very physical, especially here in the Philippines. And they take pride in defense, so you really have to strategize really well on how to break the defense. So
With a Japan B League team, I just want to ask Juan about his experiences when he played for the B League. Go ahead, Juan.
right. Oh wow. The B League league itself is just growing. It's nice. It's a nice league to play in. Very organized. A lot of talent as well. And my experience over there in Japan, it was fun. It was fun actually. Just being on your own, adapting to different culture, the way of living there. You get to meet more friends, more people. And you deal with things on your own, and that's the thrill of it. Well, before Surabaya, I got a call up from Gilas. This was during
Oh
Feb.
yeah. Yes,
That
please
was one of the
talk to
main
us more about that.
that was one of the reasons why I went back home. I'm thankful for the coaching staff and the management who gave me another shot and another opportunity to represent the flag and country. That was a solid experience. So being with a group of veterans. We had a training camp composed of the TNT guys, really. So definitely learned a lot from that group. I was trying to be like a sponge, suck in as much as information as I can to grow as a player, ABL experience, I was there for about, I think, a good 11 days. It was in Bali, Indonesia, a great place to play basketball outdoor for the 3x3. Great vibe, really. And tournament was great, no? It was an composed of club teams around Asia, Indonesia, Malaysia, Brunei, other teams. No? So it's a pretty solid experience. No?
Favorite practice, drill or exercise?
Favorite drill? Probably a three-man weave layup. So
Oh.
you get loose, you get warmed up, up and down, a lot of running. And then think of it as my plyo workout. You do a lot of layups. So three-man weave. No?
Most memorable experience with UP and playing in the UAP, I guess.
Right. With UP, probably the time we made it to the finals, but we fell short against Ateneo. And also, our out of the country trips, because that made us bond a lot more off the court, on the court, got to know more about each other, and that's how, sort of like a team building somehow. It helps prepare for the season, getting used to playing and with each other. So,
Right, yeah.
UAAP, definitely the fans, the crowd. I definitely miss the atmosphere. The UP community, most definitely, of course. Always been there since day one. Yeah, really just the UAP vibes, no? The crowd cheering, the drums, the drum roll. It's the adrenaline kicks in and all that. So, yeah.
What's it like for you who played for UP, Dugong
Yeah.
UP, IS, UP, finally? All the profanity that you can
Right.
think of winning a championship after 36 years.
Wow, it was an overwhelming experience. Even being from the crowd stand point of view, I was tears of joy. Ibang feeling. I saw a lot of guys like Coach Eric Altamirano was there. I think they were the last group of guys who won the championship, and it made the community unite again. So it was a great feeling, not just for me, but the entire UP community. Shout out to the whole the season 84 UP group that made
Champs.
the champs.
Yeah.
Salute, salute.
Dream matchup.
So if you haven't played against Stanley Pringle, I wanna see how it's like to play against him. I went head to head against Waij, the guy from Lebanon, the lefty.
Araki?
Yes,
Araki?
yes, yes,
Yeah.
yes.
Oh.
Comparison-wise, I'd say he's like the Manu Ginobili of Asia. He's not athletic, but he's very smart. His decision making, the way he involves his teammates, his impact is different. He doesn't force anything. Force shots. He finds the best option. That's what a point guard does, and that's what I try to simulate from him. It's fun. It's fun to be around with Javi. Such a quiet, chill guy, laid back. Competition wise, in terms of basketball, kasi we don't play the same position. He's more of a wing. I'm more of a guard.
Who would win in a 1-on-1 game? Just for fun. Just for fun.
For sure, si Javi. Yeah. 6'5", a guy who can shoot 3-and-D. Right now, he's trying to transition more of a 1-2. Yeah, I mean, Javi's an all-around player. He has the length, shooter, and can do basically everything on the court. So
humble lang si Juan, pero Javi, di mo na ako mababack down. Kaya ka natalunin. Joke lang.
Yun, di na talaga.
Di na. It won't be a walk in the park.
Just back me down. No handles, no, just back down. That's how it is.
Yeah.
Put a ball in the hoop, he wants to win. So, ngayon, di na haya.
Future plans, Juan.
Future plans. I mean, of course, I've been thinking about entering the PBA draft. I'm really eyeing on top two picks. So I'm really preparing myself. If ever I enter the draft for that, trying to be in my best condition. If not that, hopefully, you know, it's nice playing overseas. If I get an opportunity, because, you know, I'm all about the growth mindset, and you grow more being on your own and in a different atmosphere, different culture, environment, in a country. You know, so I mean, I would also wanna, if an opportunity comes up, I would also wanna play overseas, wherever it may be. You know, maybe in KBL or T1 in Taiwan or in Spain. So yeah, as of now, I don't know yet. So hopefully, God will guide me in the right direction.